internetten heb je zelf in de hand.
Safe internet is in your own hands. That's the theme. Well, everybody who wants to is and wants to be creative thinks this is nothing. This is not very creative. This is very a little bit boring. And then we have the online.
Could we run this?
And that's Stanislav.
Stanislav, please.
We call it Stanislav because I don't know. Maybe you know it because.
Матеротиш, а? Теротиш киллеру, а? Такие раз. Партердер.
Can you see something?
Мужчина. А. Жока. Дракулура и киллер баккашта. Курана. Матемаеш.
А что я
маю? Маешь профили?
Да. Баба. Годи карта. Релейшн статус холостина.
Холостина.
Тоже гуд. Так, так, эй, то я.
Шегете. Шегете.
Я Розба.
Шегете, профессор философии, а?
А.
Джентльмены, time is money. Мы царихим. Нетверки социальные, блоки, твистики.
Виктор,
Александр, Нидерланды. Какие задания?
Yeah. Yeah. Мы много
дали шукали. Hype campaign, right? Yeah, but you have to see it all. The last thing is at the end.
70, друже! 70! Ваш!
То це дуже баштагарата
посадка. What you see is your own photo. When you're on Hives, they pick up in this commercial, online commercial, they pick up the photos you have published yourself on Hives, they integrate it in the film. It's a quite unique thing to do, okay, and then you see yourself, so you're watching at yourself, and they're haunting you, because they know your number, they know your bank account, and your address, everything, and that's... It is quite new. It's the best, the most sent viral in Holland ever.
Yeah.
And it has been sent for 700,000 times within an hour after one Twitter message. It was unbelievable. The point I want to make is that this was very, very big success. But when we have a new business presentation to clients, and we show it, nobody knows it. While the other commercial on television, they know it all. So you always have to see it, it is always relative, because an advertising campaign just on the normal
platforms,
bourgeois broadcasting in Holland, it is more for the popularization of the campaign, was much more effective, the first ad you said, than the Stanislav. While Stanislav was, for 5 million times it was sent to each other, but you always have to realize that you mustn't wipe out the traditional media.
Well, I'm sure that we should get into that a little bit later. I think Matthew will have a couple of questions about that too. Yeah. Matthew, could you tell us a little about yourself?
Sure. Hi, I'm Matthew Atkatz. I'm the executive creative director of Riot. We're the digital group for 180 Amsterdam. And we're about a year and 5 months old. We were created to meet the digital needs for Adidas Worldwide, who's one of our primary clients. And the way that we basically work is Riot is an idea-driven interactive shop. And we do a whole range of integrated work with our 180 counterparts. I actually wanted to talk to you guys about a couple of different projects that we've done for basketball for All-Star Weekend, which might not be a huge sport in this country, but with Adidas Global in North America and in China, basketball is a massive sport. And I was going to show you 2 years worth of All-Star Weekend work. Just for those of you that don't know, All-Star Weekend is basically an exhibition game that happens halfway through the basketball season. And it's not a competitive game, it's just a great opportunity to take players from the East Coast Conference and the West Coast Conference, and we get them together and they have a lot of fun. So we have an athlete called Dwight Howard, who is probably one of the most marketable sports properties in North America right now. And for All-Star Weekend 2009, what we did was we gave the young audience an inside perspective on the game through the eyes of Dwight Howard. American basketball players are incredibly sophisticated about the way that they market themselves, and they're really tapped into social media. And what we did was we basically just piggybacked onto the world of Dwight Howard, both on the court and off the court. So I'm going to just show you guys a quick video and you can get a sense of what 2009 looked like, and then we'll move on and I'll show you this year's work that's just maybe 3 or 4 weeks old now. So can we roll the first video, please?
Adidas basketball has always been about brotherhood. But this year, brotherhood gave it back to the fans, as seen through NBA All-Star Dwight Howard's eyes.
I'm gonna take you with me to Phoenix.
All-Star Weekend 2009.
I got my own cell phone. I'm gonna be taking video, pictures, text messages, and everything, because I want you guys to be a part of my experience.
For All-Star Weekend 2009, Dwight became the star, the director, and the curator of this three-day event, sharing stories, posting photos, and uploading videos. We created a 24-hour newsroom to deliver an exclusive look inside All-Star Weekend that broadcasts real-time content of the man-child in his quest to defend his slam dunk title.
Superman is in the building!
Try and stop me, yo, that's never.
Hey, did they get the videos from
We have them ready.
Did y'all see them? They look cool. They lick his lips every 2 seconds.
The newsroom delivered constant communications across owned, earned, and bought media. The campaign kicked off online with this film.
So what about the text message?
Dwight posted 29 YouTube clips that were seen by 2 million people in 3 days. He created over 80 unique pieces of content, uploading pictures, posting tweets, and even making a few prank calls.
My name is Chelsea Bill. I want to order some food, please. Let me get a tuna salad sandwich, a grilled ham and cheese sandwich, spicy fried chicken. This is for one.
This is Dwight in person. With
a pumpkin
NBA
whoopie
players.
Pie. Two Sprites. Yes, this is Mr. Billups.
Mm-hmm.
Strawberry and fresh vanilla ice cream. Thank you.
A real-time feed of content that had 80% of fans returning to the experience.
We have to play defense, defense, defense.
This
I don't care
coach.
About what happens on the offensive end, but you gotta run. You gotta move. You guys gotta play hard, Dwight. No one-handed rebounds tonight. Grab the ball with two hands.
So this platform was really built on a model that we call constant communications, which is basically the idea that we activate and engage every digital touch point for our audience and make sure that we're serving them bite-sized snacks of information and content that are relevant to them in a particular moment. And this is a pretty kind of classic example of us bringing constant communications to bear for All-Star Week in 2009. 2010 is actually a completely different approach, and I'll take you through that one next. Let's see if we can get this connection working here. Am I driving? Yeah, I'm driving. Sort of. So for 2010, what we were really trying to do is kind of take the experience a level deeper, and rather than allow people kind of an inside perspective, let's actually let young people directly engage with Dwight. So what we did was we partnered with YouTube. This is about 2 weeks old now. We partnered with YouTube. It's still live, and if you guys want to check it out, the URL is up top. And what we basically did was we allowed kids to engage directly with Dwight. We created a launch spot and then a series of YouTube innovations that were done in partnership with them that allowed us to use YouTube in innovative ways that people hadn't seen before. And I think this is actually a really good example of interactive innovation and what the medium can really do when you start to challenge people's expectations about what something like YouTube can do. So let me first just show you the spot, and then I'll quickly talk you through the interactive portion of it.
The basket is still 10 feet high. The free throw line is still 15 feet away. The ball still weighs 22 ounces. But now I'm faster. Stronger. Lighter.
I am how the game will be measured from now on.